Hello friends, in this video I am going to discuss comma rules in English language. So I'll discuss 21 comma rules. So without wasting time, let's get started. Rule number one, use comma to separate words or word groups with a series of three or more. Alright, in a long sentences which consist of many words, you have to separate them. For example, let me give you an example. My state is to be split among my sister, comma, daughter, comma, son and nephew. So there is an exception. You may or may not use a comma before end. It's upon you, it's on your choice to use a comma in this series. You may or may not use comma before end in this series. Alright, rule number two, use a comma to separate two adjectives when the word can be inserted between them. For example, he is strong, healthy, strong, comma, healthy men. Alright, two adjectives used simultaneously, strong and healthy. To separate them, you have to use comma. And rule number three, use a comma when an alpha adjective is used with other adjectives. Alright, so to test whether ly adjective, ly word is an adjective, see it can be used along with the noun. For example, let me give you an example. Felix was a lovely young boy. Alright, here in this sentence you can see that two adjectives are used, one with ly, lonely, and second is another without ly, young. So you have to separate them using a comma. Rule number four, use commas before or surrounding the name, title of a person, directly address. For example, in this example you can see, will you, Aisha, do that assignment for me? So here you referring to addressing to Aisha, the name. Alright, so comma is used. In the second sentence, yes doctor, I will. So here yes is used to address to a doctor, so comma is used to the address before a name or title of a person, directly address. And then you have to, obviously you have to capitalize the title to whom you are addressing. Rule number five is use a comma to separate the day of month from the year and after the year. So in writing dates, you have to separate the day, month and year, and also the places with that address by using commas. For example, Kathleen met her husband on December 5, 2003, in Mill Valley, California. And rule number 5, part B, if any part of the date is omitted, if in this address, if the date is omitted, then you have to leave out the comma. There is no need to use comma if the date is leave out. So there is no date here, you can see. They met in December 2003, year is mentioned there, month is mentioned there, but date is not mentioned. If date is not mentioned, there is no need to use comma. Rule number six, use a comma to separate the city from the state and after the state in a document. For example, if you use two letter capitalized form of a state in a document, you should not need a comma after the state. And you have to keep in bear in mind that with addresses on envelopes mailed through a post office, do not use any punctuation. So here are two examples. I lived in San Francisco, comma, California, comma, for 20 years. Whereas an address on envelope through a post office, there is no comma. For example, I live in San Francisco, comma, California, for 20 years. And rule number seven is use comma to surround degrees, titles with names. Commas are no longer required around JR or SR. Alright, commas never set off second, third and so forth. For example, commas are used to surround degrees or titles. For example, Almoni, MD. So this is his title. So we use comma before they eat. And rule number 8, use comma to set off expressions that interrupt sentence flow. So when you take a pause, you use a comma. In this sentence, I am, you take a pause after I am, place a comma, and then you continue. As you have probably noticed, very nervous about this. Rule number 9, when starting a sentence with a weak clause, use a comma after it. Alright, and then conversely, do not use a comma when the sentence starts with a strong clause followed by a weak. So when starting a sentence with a weak clause, you have to use a comma. For example, if you are not sure about this, so this is a weak clause, after weak clause you have to use a comma, and then let me know now. And rule number 10, use a comma after phrases of more than 3 words that begin a sentence. Use a comma after phrases of 2 more than 3 word phrases of more than 3 words that begin a sentence. If the phrase has fewer than 3 words, then the comma is optional. For example, this is a phrase which consists of 3 words, so we use comma. For example, to apply for this job, you must have previous experience. Okay, rule number 11, if something or someone is sufficiently identified, the description following it is considered non-essential and should be surrounded by commas. For example, Freddy, comma, who has a limp, comma, was in an auto incident. So here you use comma to separate this non-essential parts. Okay, the description following it is considered non-essential, then you should surround them by commas. And rule number 12, use a comma to separate two strong clauses joining by a coordinating conjunction. You know about coordinating conjunction and but, for, and nor, when, wise. Okay, 7 coordinating conjunction, and you can omit the comma if the clauses are both short. For example, I have painted the entire house, comma, but. So here coordinating conjunction is used. Before a coordinating conjunction, you have to place a comma, but he is still working on standing the doors. Alright, rule number 13, use the comma to separate two sentences if it will help avoid confusion. For example, I choose the colors red and green, comma, and blue was his first choice. So you have to use in this sentence, you see that use comma to separate two sentences if it will help you avoiding confusion. All right, to avoid confusion in this long sentence, you have to use comma. Rule number 14, a comma splice is an error caused by joining two strong clauses with only comma instead of separating the clauses with a conjunction, semicolon, or period. And this mistake is known as comma splice, means inappropriate use of comma. So a run-on sentence which is incorrect is created by joining two strong clauses without any punctuation. For example, time flies when we are having fun, comma, we are always having fun. So comma splices their inappropriate use of comma in this sentences. Two clauses, strong clauses are joined using inappropriate comma. All right, and in the second sentence we saw run-on sentence, this is also an error. Time flies when we are having fun, we are always having fun. All right, this not make a sense. So the correct use of usage of comma in this sentence should be like that: time flies when we are having fun, semicolon is used, and then we are always having fun. All right, and now we'll see rule number 15. If the subject does not appear in front of second verb, do not use comma. For example, he thought quickly, Here he is the subject, you know. If subject does not appear in front of second verb here is ansa. So subject does not appear in front of second verb, so do not use comma. He thought quickly but still did not answer correctly. Rule number 16, use commas to introduce or interrupt direct quotations which are shorter than three lines. For example, a quotation is given, he actually said, then use comma and then introduce the quotation using quotation marks. I do not care. And then rule number 17, use a comma to separate statement from a question. So here one statement and one question are used simultaneously in a sentence. To separate them, use a comma. I can go, then comma, and can't I, that is question. All right, to separate them you have to use a comma. Rule number 18, use the comma to separate contrasting part of a sentence. For example, this is my money, not yours. So these two statements are contrast to each other, opposite of each other. Use comma to separate them. Rule number 19, use a comma when beginning a sentence with introductory words or phrases. All right, well, so these introductory words are well, now, yes. So you use such words to introduce a sentence. So you have to place a comma after them. For example, you say, yes, I do not need that report, and you say, well, comma, I never thought I had lived to see the day. All right, rule number 20, use comma surrounding words such as therefore and however when they are used as interrupters. For example, I would, comma, therefore, comma, like a response. I would be happy, comma, however, again, comma, to volunteer for the Red Cross. So you have to use comma surrounding words such as therefore and however when they are used as interrupters in a sentence. Rule number 21, use either a comma or semicolon before introductory words such as namely, that is, for example, or for instance. So these are introductory words or phrases. For example, for instance, when you use them, okay, you have to use a comma before that introductory words in a sentence. When they are followed by a series of items, use a comma after introductory words. For example, you may be required to bring many items, comma, for example, sleeping bag, pens and warm clothing. Or you can say, you may be required to bring many items, then semicolon, for example, and place a comma, and then you can say sleeping bags, comma, pens and warming clothes. So this is all about usage of comma. The